engaged in the enforcement side of the problem know that very clearly. The dealer always has clients help, not a doctor. And the clients help will always motivate your dealers. So, the hope lies in prevention. The hope lies with the next generation and in the education of kids, as I was lucky enough to have received, that drugs are not just the answer. And now, I'm also a mom, and my baby, as you may have noticed, being a mom, twice over. So I can look at my responsibility for my child and my future children's education that I can give them so that they can make their own informed choices. And I can look at the environment that they're entering into in society today. We all are aware of the opioid epidemic. There's a statistic from Health and Human Services that says about 80% of people who use heroin first misused prescription opioids. The International Narcotics Control Board reported that in 2015, Americans represented about 99.7% of the world's hydrocodone consumption. Vicodin, legal, prescription, painkiller. 99.7% of it. And we are also, I'm assuming, all of you here aware of how my community of artists and actors continues to lose some of its greatest artists to drugs. And also how my community continues to contribute to false messages that drugs are the answer, that drugs are fine to do, and they're harmless, and they're fun, and they're cool. So that's why I am so happy about what the foundation is doing. The facts of how drugs destroy your body and your mind are pretty cut and dry. It's pretty clear that it's not the way to go. But that choice and that decision has to be made by every individual, not enforced upon them with threats of punishment and judgment and ostracism and so forth. That can trip up that instinct to just do what you're told not to do, you know? On a personal note, I consider being drug-free more rebellious, way more rebellious than doing drugs. And a sign of strength. Life can be hard and it can be painful, but I take it as a point of pride to weather the travails of life without drugs. Very Very literal example is childbirth. There are many viewpoints about it, and I totally understand all of them, but I really am excited to have my first child at home and have a natural childbirth. And there are situations which will preclude that from happening, but the greatest good was not to do otherwise. In my case, I was resolute and we had no complications, and I was able to have a drug-free delivery. Very cool. Very admirable work.
Thank you.
It's empowering to those who benefit from it in many places that it's implemented. It's inspiring to me, and I thank you for having me here. Save your time.